Overnight, the ship sails north to Brennisund, via a passage that leads under a local landmark, the Rorvik Bridge. The clearance under the bridge is just 41 metres, the same height as some of the ship's antennae. But the ship's navigation light rises more than 44 metres above the water, putting it on a collision course with the bridge.
We will not pass underneath the bridge if we don't do something.
So the only way to sail under the bridge is to disconnect the antennae and lower the light. The responsibility lies with a pair of engineers who have just half an hour to complete the job.
So then we should have 3 feet or 1 meter clearance. But still, we know it's doable. It's still a little bit exciting.
But the elements could change everything.
When we are in these tight areas, the two things that concern us most is the wind as well as the current. That's the most important factors.
Squeezing through, the ship heads onward to Brennisund.
I saw a rope is going to the power ship's propeller.
One of six thick mooring ropes linked to sunken concrete anchor blocks had drifted around the propeller shaft. If it got caught, the snarl could have caused mayhem in the engine room. The tug held the power ship in place while the mooring crew lashed her to surrounding anchor points. All hands worked into the night without a winch, still inoperable after a leak in the hydraulic system. The mooring crew had to think of another way to haul 70-ton anchor chains. A lead rope attached to the chain was threaded up through a bow hole, or house, then back down to the tug where it was secured onto the tug's winch. Using the tug to pull the lead rope, they planned to haul the hefty links from the tug up onto the deck of the power ship.
Tamam, şalama ile birlikte orada kal. Tamam, orada kal. Ya bir metre daha vereceğim, tamam.
Tamam, gelin. It's gonna be enough to pull the rope, chain, everything.
Heave up, heave up.
Link by massive link, the heavy anchor chain was heaved up onto the bow. With one end of the chain shackled to the power ship's deck, the big tug backed away. The rest of the chain slid off the tug's stern. Once the chain was fully extended, the 11-ton anchor could be released from its steel holding cables. Cutting a cable under high tension called for extreme care. The turning circle was incredibly tight. The ship was just 20 meters from the pier and 15 meters from rocks.
It's very important that I know the ship. I know the ship exactly. You must not go over the limit where you don't feel you can handle this.
The rudders were turned hard to port. The portside propeller was then put into reverse at full speed, while the starboard propeller continued to drive forward at half speed. At the front of the ship, a pair of thrusters drew the bow to port, positioning the ship parallel to the pier. If all that was executed correctly, the engines could then be used to draw the ship sideways beside the dock, then back to the loading ramp area. A confident captain lowered the ramp as the ship reversed into position.
touchdown. 6 minutes to fire.
The entire maneuver was executed in 8 minutes.
Like a switch watch.
Without any lifelines from tugboats, harbor pilots, or fellow officers. On approach to a busy waterway, the staff captain kept a close eye out for any unexpected traffic ahead.
You have to think that it's not a car. We cannot stop like that. So, no, with that speed, we need about 1 mile.
This time, the strait was unusually clear. Local harbor pilots were back on board to help the captain steer to the pier with ease.
100 meters.
100.
Okay.
The captain turned the ship to come alongside.
45 meters.
Okay.
After on bridge, check the swing on port side.
From forward, the clearance on the swing will be around 35, 40 meters.
But one of the pilots was alarmed. Convinced that the captain hadn't left enough room off the bow to clear a warship, docked ahead.
Come here, sir.
Siamo liberi, sì, siamo liberi. La nave, guarda, lo sta nave.
A newcomer to the bridge could be forgiven for thinking that the two ships were about to collide. But the view was deceptive. The two vessels were, in fact, hundreds of meters clear.
Bridge, I confirm the swing is clear on the starboard side forward.
It's clear from the warship.
They don't understand that the point of view from the bridge, it's different from the reality.
Only 15 minutes after turning to dock.
All clear, all clear.
The ship was alongside the pier, right on time.
Very good.